Did you know that over 60% of Filipino adolescents are considered to have a smartphone addiction? Whether checking out the latest posts on FB, the hottest TikTok trends, the trending issues on Twitter, or maybe playing mobile games, or binge-watching on Netflix, our phones are like a rabbit hole. A 5-minute break becomes a 4-hour idle time. And over time, this adds up, distracting us from the more important things in life. With the short and limited time that we have here on Earth, are we using our time wisely? You see, the way we spend our time shows what we value. And in Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verses 9 to 10, talks about two things in life that are of true value. It says, "Enjoy life with the wife whom you love, all the days of your vain life that he has given you under the sun, because that is your portion in life and in your toil at which you toil under the sun. Whatever your hand finds to do, do it with your might, for there is no work or thought or knowledge or wisdom in Sheol to which you are going." Firstly, this text encourages us to enjoy our relationship with our parents, with our siblings, and for those of you who are parents with your children. Though no family is perfect, God placed you in your family for a reason. Be intentional with spending time with them. A simple, "How's your day?" actually goes a long way. Be present in their lives as much as you can. Some of us might find this hard because of certain issues. But let's be reminded that God can do great things with the time we invest in our families. Second, we're called to value work. For the adults in different industries and for the students through your studies. Work is not a punishment from God, nor a mere capitalist construct that we can choose not to do. God calls us to spend our time in work to involve us in taking care of His creation for His glory. According to author Charles Spurgeon, man was not created to be idle. He was not elected to be idle. He was not redeemed to be idle. He was not quickened to be idle. And he is not sanctified by God's grace to be idle. Today, let's examine the things that distract us from family, work, and God. And in humility, in faith, let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the one who died and was raised from the dead to reconcile us back to the family of God, and the one who is able to give us rest. Let's allow him to change our hearts towards the things that truly matters in life. We only have one life to live, and it only counts when we live it for the glory of God. Make your today count. God bless.